Welcome to this video. In the last video, we have seen what is nanomaterial. So nanomaterial, it is the material whose any one dimension is less than 100 nanometer. Now if one dimension reduced to nanoscale, we know it is quantum well. If two dimensions reduced to nanoscale, it is quantum wire. And if all the three dimensions are reduced to nanoscale, it is quantum dot. So this part we have seen it in the last video. So in this video, we will see some techniques how to synthesize nanomaterials. Synthesis techniques we will see. Now there are two approaches to synthesize nanomaterial: top down and bottom up. Simple meaning is from bigger to smaller and smaller to bigger. So top down, it means a bulk material or a big size material, we cut it to reduce the size, and we cut it till it reduces to nanoscale. So that we call top down. And what is bottom up? So first we have separate atoms. So these individual atoms, they come together, they assemble together, they grow in size up to nanoscale. So that is the bottom up. So there are two approaches, top down and bottom up technique. So this is the diagram for top down and bottom up. So this is the bulk material. We cut it. So we get now, for example, see, this is the cube. So it is cut into smaller cubes. Again, these cubes are cut to again decrease the size, and finally we get the nanoparticles. So these are the particles with nano size. So this is top down. And what is the bottom up? So here we have individual atoms. These atoms come together and we form a group of atoms. We call it cluster. And these clusters again, they come together, they assemble together, and we get nanoparticle. Okay, so these are the two approaches in production technique: top down and bottom up technique. Okay, so first we shall see what is bottom up technique. Okay, so in the bottom up technique, the material is built up atom by atom. So there are two approaches. Molecular self-assembly first we say. So what is the molecular self-assembly? In the molecular self-assembly, the atoms or molecules come together without external management. They come together without external management. Okay, so see this diagram. So here atoms are in state of random motion. So there is no any external force or no any guidance is there. So you can see these atoms are in state of random motion. So in this state of random motion, there is some possibility that these atoms come together and they get linked. So when these atoms, they get linked, see, the different orientations are possible. So they may come together and they assemble in this fashion, or they may assemble in this fashion. Okay, so different, I have shown you only two orientations, but actually different orientations are possible. And we know these different orientations, they have different energy, or their stability is different. Now suppose this orientation has less energy and therefore it is stable, so this assembly will continue. And what will happen in this case? It is unstable with higher energy. So atoms come together, they assemble, and again, since it is unstable, they disperse. Okay, and this assembly will continue. So this is called as molecular self-assembly. Self-assembly means what? The atoms, they come together without external management or without external guidance. So we call it as a self-assembly. Actually, biological molecules, they have the ability to self-assemble. And how to assemble, that information is transcripted in the DNA, and then it is read by some processes. These biological molecules, they come together and they form the tissue, organ, etc. So we learn this ability to assemble from nature, or we try to imitate the nature, and that gives a separate branch, we call it as a biomimetics. Okay, so we learn this technique of self-assembly from nature, from these biological molecules, and this is called biomimetics. So artificial synthesis of vitamins or antibiotic is the example of biomimetic. Now next type is the positional assembly. So it is also bottom-up technique. Okay, here the components or the atoms or molecules, they are not in state of random motion. Okay, they are not in state of random motion, but they are deliberately brought together by some external force. They are brought together by some restoring force, like electrostatic force of attraction, and when they come together, they get linked. Okay, so here some external force is compelling the atoms to come together and to get linked. So this we call as a positional assembly. Okay, so this is about the bottom up technique. Okay, so in bottom up, the atoms come together, they grow in size up to nanoscale. So that is the bottom up technique. In bottom up, again we have two types: molecular self assembly. Here there is no external force acting, so atoms are in state of random motion. And the next is the positional assembly. So here atoms or molecules are brought together by some external force. Now there are different examples for bottom up technique, like electrodeposition, chemical vapor deposition. So these are the some examples of bottom up. Okay, now next is the top down. So in top down, the bigger size or the bulk material is cut, or it is sliced and it is reduced in size up to nanoscale. Okay, so here we use different methods like cutting, carving, molding, etc. So we reduce the size up to nanoscale. So when we use these traditional methods like cutting, carving, okay, some surface imperfections may occur. And secondly, there is no control over the size of the material. So different particles, different nanoparticles may be of different size. So these are the disadvantages of this top-down technique. But the main advantage is that it is simple and cheaper, and it can be used for mass production. Okay, so these are the production techniques. There are two approaches: top down and bottom up technique. Okay, so we stop here. In the next video, we will learn some tools that are used to study the nanoparticles. Okay, friends, thank you.